In this tutorial, I'll show you how to reveal text in Premiere Pro. Let's get to it. Here we are in Premiere. I've already added a new sequence. Now I'm going to select the type tool, click and type something. If you have essential graphics panel enabled, you should see all of the settings, such as the font, size, position and stuff like that. I'm going to make the text slightly bigger and align it to the center of the screen. After that, I'm going to open effects window and search for transform. It'll be under distort, drag it to the text layer, then search for crop. Also add it to the text layer. After that, we're going to head over to the effect controls panel and make sure the order of the effects is correct, meaning that the crop comes first and then comes the transform. Now we're going to adjust the crop settings first. Let's select it so it's highlighted, and you should see this blue rectangle in the program monitor indicating the edges of the crop. Now you have to decide what direction you want the text to animate in. In my example, I want the text to animate up from the bottom. For this, I'm going to move the bottom edge of the crop and move it very close to the text, almost all the way, just leave some space between the two. And then inside of the transform, we need the position settings. Let's create a keyframe for position by clicking on the stopwatch icon. That will create a keyframe, and let's move that keyframe forward in time. So this is the end position of the text, where it will be after it animates in. Now let's add a starting position for the text, and that will be at the bottom. And for this, I'm going to increase the Y position and start increasing it until it goes all the way out of screen. And then I'm going to move 1 second forward from here, so plus 1 second, and move the second keyframe to this point. Then I'm going to expand the arrow next to position. Then I'm also going to make this bigger so that we can see the graph better. Then select both keyframes, right click any of them, go into temporal interpolation, ease in, right click again, and ease out. And now this is our graph. You should see the tiny blue handle. So let's drag the second blue handle all the way to the left to create this kind of graph. It'll make the animation very smooth, starting off fast, and then it'll slow down to the end. And the only thing that's left is to add motion blur. And the reason we have used transform effect is because it allows us to add motion blur. If we scroll down to the shutter angle settings, let's uncheck use composition shutter angle and then increase the shutter angle to 90 or 180. That will give you a nice amount of motion blur. So now if we do the preview, this is how our text reveal animation looks at the moment. And if you find the bottom edge where the text animates from to be too sharp, you can go back to the crop settings and add edge feather, some like 5 or 10. That should be good enough. It'll soften out the edge. And you can make the text animate from any direction as long as you adjust the crop and transform settings accordingly. That is it for this one. Thank you guys for watching.